All right, ladies and gentlemen, and here we go. Another day, another association mode. We are going up against the New York Knicks, the Minnesota Timberwolves, and the Detroit Pistons. And this is the order that it's going to happen. We are going to play in a highlight game against the New York Knicks. We are going to simulate the game against the Minnesota Timberwolves. And at the end of the video, we're going to talk about this new rule in the NBA. It's all about delay of game. So that's all coming up for you, and it looks like we lost against the Knicks. I believe we simulated this game, and we lost against them, and that was a little bit of a bummer. So now I think we need some retribution. We need to play this game, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to get right into it. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, the New York Knicks. All right, ladies and gentlemen, New York Knicks taking on the Boston Celtics. The Boston Celtics did lose to the New York Knicks early last week in a stunning simulation loss. And here we go. We want some revenge on Mr. Melo. That's what we want. We want some revenge in this game. Going down low early to Bass. Bass, three-point play. Converting early on in the first quarter. Rondo setting it up to Olenek. Olenek gets a jumper and dunks it in there. Three-point shot by the Knicks, and that would be a killer in this game. J.R. Smith would have 20 points and shoot from 7 and 15 in the field goals. All right, inbound play here for Dett. Immediate shot, sinking it. Fredette becoming one of my favorite players at the end of the first quarter, 17-10. Boston, 7-point lead. Fredette, 3-point play to start off the second quarter, and it does go down. Boston in control. New York Knicks, next play, answer back, another 3-point shot, and they know how to do it. Meta World Peace making his spot on that New York Knicks team. Another 3-point shot by Bunyarny, wide open, sinks it. The 3-point shots were killers for the Boston Celtics in this game. Alley-oops. If it wasn't 3-point shots, it was alley-oops. J.R. Smith, Raymond Felton, Meta World Peace, Carmelo Anthony, all really good scoring. Meta World Peace, Raymond Felton, J.R. Smith, all double digits in this game. At halftime, I was so surprised. Chuck Hayes being the best damn player on the team at this point. He made 5 of 6 free throws. It was very, very surprising. Chuck Hayes, 5th best scorer on the team with 7 points. Another easy layup. It seems like the more the game went on, the more Boston started to fall apart. They were starting to slow up. All right, beginning of the 4th quarter here. George Wallace not going to take no for an answer. Goes for a 3-point play and takes it. Rondo stealing the ball, going up to Bradley, and whenever Bradley's got the ball, it's going to be an explosive finish. Dunk and one situation. He would convert that. Alright, we're down there. We're going in. He can't get the ball in the hoop. Going back down for the New York Knicks. The New York Knicks, another 3-point shot. It was actually a 2-point shot upon further review. And the Boston Celtics just lost it. Bogans trying to get him back into there. But the 3-point shots came too little, too late. Boston Celtics lose 68-63. What a heartbreaking loss here. I want to beat the Knicks, damn it. It's bullshit. They came, they saw. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. We are about to simulate the Minnesota Timberwolves game, and let's get started. Oh, maybe we should go to the next quarter here. 19-23. Oh my god, okay. 40-22. Oh, yuck. 42-57. I don't even think it's worth. Oh. So disgusting. We might make a comeback here. Come on. No. Oh, no. Ugh. 55-74. We got worked. We got worked over. Yuck. 11 assists for Rondo. Rubio. Rondo only 5, but he had 11 points. Yuck. Oh, that's so disgusting. All right, let's actually simulate through this, and I want to see some headlines before we get to the topic video. All right, Kenyon Martin asking Knicks for a trade. That's interesting. All right, so Allen is out. Bosch coming back to practice. Nuggets topple Thunder. Meta World Peace doesn't like New York. Martin asking for a trade. Wow. Trouble in New York Paradise. All right. Where? Shoot, I went the whole wrong way. I was like, where are we? Damn it. Bradley lights up Clippers as Celtics cling to win. Smith leads Knicks. Williams drops season high. Okay. So, yes, we are on a two-game losing streak right now. In the past two games, let's see, we've lost two, won one, lost two. Hopefully, we win one. Ugh. This is so bad. We are slowly falling behind. These 2-1 games and losses category is not a good situation. So we're going to have to play this Celtics game right here, right now, and try to recover. All right, what is up, everybody? Here we are in the topic portion of the video and watching the NBA opening games. I've noticed something. I've noticed that if you touch the ball after you score and it happens to go out of bounds, it's delay of game. What does this mean? Well, and there's two different situations I'm going to talk about. One is dunking it and then batting it to the out of bounds, which is totally agreeable. I accept that. The second one is a free throw where, say, if you're Carlos Boozer and you're about to, you know, nudge a guy out and get the rebound off of a bad free throw, and he misses, but it's the first shot, not the second shot. So the ball goes back to the ref. You can't grab that ball and give it to the ref. The ref has to go get it. You can't touch the ball, or else it's delay of game, and they will call a turnover, and it will be on you, and the other team will get the possession. The problem with this is that instinctively, if a ball is coming towards you as a basketball player, you get it, you grab it, you hold it, you touch it. If you dunk the ball and you're coming down and it's bouncing to you, you grab it and you kind of lightly toss it away. I've seen two or three instances of this delay of game call, and two or three times they've been, okay, you know what, I can see how that would be cheating and how that would be delaying of game and giving the team more rest, but it defeats the purpose of a rule of delay of game. Now, I understand if it was called the injure a fan rule, because that's the only thing it would really do is if I lightly pushed it and maybe there was a toddler there who had a soft head and the ball accidentally hit him in the head. You know, you gotta be safe. But with this, it just seems like you're delaying the game more by turning the ball over, giving them a technical foul, and waiting to shoot free throws. This isn't baseball. This isn't a game where you constantly just rule. Like, you just gotta focus and just play the game. Let them play, and it'll work out for you. That's my take on the situation. I'm not a big fan of this delay of game rule, but I'm not an NBA player, and I like seeing NBA players get really upset, and I like them arguing with the refs. I like a little controversy. So for me, this rule is good and bad. It's bad for the game because it's going to slow the games down, it's going to make people get technicals and all that other stuff, but it's also good for the game because I love me. When the replacement refs in the NFL were reffing, football was 20% much more fun to watch, and I didn't even have money on those games. So let me know what you think about this new rule in the comments below, and also tell me about this episode in general. Tell me how it was. That being said, Derek D. Ginger King. Checking out.